I don't know what that noise was, but ignore it. I don't know why it decided to make that noise right when I started, but anyways. I'm just gonna be real with you guys, not that I haven't been real with you guys, because I think if you know me and you've watched my previous videos, I talk about, you know, being real and authentic and just doing my best to be myself. And when I say I'm gonna be real right now, like, I just feel like poop. Like, I do not feel great about myself right now. I kind of feel like failure, and I know those things aren't true. I know that I'm not a failure. I know that I'm a good person, and I know that I do my best to succeed at the things I'm passionate about. But honestly, the reason I'm in this funk is my own fault. It is, because in my head, I tell myself that my eating disorder outlet. Isn't as bad as self-harming. And I told you guys in a previous video that I used to self-harm, and I had an eating disorder for 10 plus years, and then I wouldn't say I got rid of it, but it was managed for the most part, and which my eating disorder was binging and purging mostly. There was some anorexia at some parts of my life, but it's mostly been binging when I was younger, and then that turned into binging and purging, and then when that was seeming like it was killing me, basically, I was like, okay, well, I'll try anorexia. And then back to binging and purging, and then stopped for, let's say, 5 or 6 years. And then now, since COVID hit, I've been struggling again with purging and binging and purging. So I'll purge sometimes when I just have like a regular meal, because I'll feel anxious and weird about it. And that's not easy for me to admit, because, you know, sometimes people may have said comments to me, know that that's disgusting. And yeah, okay, I understand it's gross to throw up your food, but that's how I cope with my issues, and I'm sorry that that disgusts you. And I'm doing my best not to be that person, but I can't help it sometimes. And I'm working on that. Anyways, what I was going to really rant about today is just myself, and just being frustrated with my choices. And like I was saying before, it is my fault I am in this predicament right now, feeling the way I am, and kind of kicking myself for acting out last night and binging and purging. But I did eat after I binge and purge, and that did not turn into another binge and purge, so that was good. Because sometimes it'll trigger me to eat more food, and I'll be like, oh no, I have to like get rid of this too. But instead of doing that, I told my BFF Bra that I was talking to you last night. If you're watching this, thank you. And I told her that I wasn't feeling so hot, so I was gonna go to bed and cuddle with Kylie, and that would probably make me feel better and not focus on feeling uncomfortable with my food. But I also was really tired, so that helped. Sometimes even when I'm really tired, I'll push myself to turn it into a binge, but last night I was like, no, I'm just gonna go to sleep, I'm not gonna do that. But then today, these feelings are not great. I feel gross, I feel fat, I feel icky, and yes, fat is a feeling. I know people say it's not a feeling, but it is. It's a feeling. I feel fat, okay? and I'm gonna work out, and I'm gonna try to feel better about myself. And today I just woke up and I was just like, I can't do today. I don't want to do it. Also, today's the first day of being back in school, and I'm gonna be real. I really hate it. I hate doing online school. I hate it. I'm sorry, but I do. I do it because I have to, and because I love Jack, and I want him to learn, and I want him to succeed. But man, do I really hate it. I am not, there's a fly over here. I'm not cut out to be a teacher. I'm not a teacher of these things. I can educate you about things I'm passionate about, things that I learned because they interest me, but I'm not a teacher of, you know, ABCs and maps and the world, and you know, it just, I sit through it and I do it and I get through it. I'm not like super happy about it, but I'm also not an a-hole. I'm not like, oh, I hate this. I don't know why you have to do this. I'm like, this is something we have to do. We do it together. We try to make it fun when we can. And the thing is that it's hard because I know he dislikes it too. And so I have to be like, ooh, we're gonna do schoolwork, yay. And I'm just like, no, we're not. But today we didn't do the first day of school. And yeah, we just didn't do it. I'm sorry, but we didn't do it. And that's just the reality sometimes. Sometimes you just have a bad day and you're like, F that, I'm not doing that today. And there's always tomorrow. We can do it tomorrow, and we can do what we missed, and it'll be fine, you know? We'll be fine. But honestly, I really, really am looking into him going back to school, and it seems right now that everything is remote learning, which I understand is the best they can do right now, but I am literally going crazy doing this school stuff, you know? It's just not for me. But the stress of getting back to school, I think, also made me kind of get overwhelmed yesterday and reach out to that unhealthy behavior and do the type of thing I shouldn't do in order to get through those difficult feelings of I don't want to, it's a pain in my butt, and my just how I feel more in control. And I don't hate myself for that. It is what it is. You know, I'll try to get better, and I could have reached out earlier to my friend, when I acted out earlier, but I chose not to because I chose that I was going to do that, and it was gonna make me feel better or whatever, which it honestly maybe did for a little bit, and then I just was back to feeling crappy again, so it really doesn't help all that much. So, if you're struggling with that, let me know. I mean, we all have our vices. I'm not saying that they're good, but even if you don't have an eating disorder, if you have, like, you know, I don't know why there's such a long pause right there because I can't think of the freaking word, but if you have, like, another disorder that is difficult for you to manage, you know, I can totally relate. Just because they're different doesn't mean we can't understand each other, understand where we're coming from. They all, you know, basically stem from similar things and are reasons, there are reasons we use them to escape, you know, so. But that's just where I'm at today. I want to say that I have come a long way, because when I was at my worst, when I felt like this, I would literally feel like I wanted to die. But I have done a lot to get to where I am today, and I know it's not perfect, but it is better, and I do have to recognize that. And and that I'm always trying to do better than I did the day before. And I know there are days that I don't, where I'm just like, you know, I don't care today. I'm going to do what I want. I don't care about the consequences, which is not great, because that is very selfish, and I have a family, so I cannot be selfish like that all the time. And I have to be careful about my actions, also because I do have a child. So, in case you are wondering, no, I do not act out when Jack is here. I am able to control myself enough to not do that. Which also makes you think, well, then why aren't you not able to control yourself when he's not here? So, that's something to think about. Maybe because I hold it in until that last second, and I'm like, phew, now I can let it all out. It's not great. It's not perfect, but it's better than being a whole mess while he's here. So, you know, that is something to look positively at. And, you know, I'm just taking it one day at a time, just like everybody else. That's all we can do. And just hope for the best and just get our shiz together. You know, just be the best that we can be. I did just want to rant about myself, and I guess that's good. I'm thinking about how my actions affect myself and how I need to fix that and do things that are gonna make me happy and stop self-sabotaging. So that would be great. Thanks, B. I appreciate that insight. Anyways, I hope you guys had a great weekend, and I look forward to hearing from you and knowing what's going on with you, and if you're struggling with anything, and if you found anything interesting about yourself that you didn't realize before, and just trying to look introspectively and, you know, figure out how you're getting in your own way. Because I do it a lot without even realizing it sometimes. But I love you guys, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.